Silence. Om. Good morning, students. In the last class, we discussed about the electrochemical cell or the galvanic cell, its construction and working. How the electrochemical cell is converting the chemical energy into electrical energy. We discussed about the cell potential. We discussed about the electrode potential. And also we discuss about the cell potential. How to calculate the cell potential by the use of the cathode and anode, that also we discuss. We have solved numerical for a calculation of the cell potential, standard electrode potential and standard cell potential. Now you see, whatever we have calculated the cell potential, that is at the standard condition. Means the concentration is 1 molar. We calculate E naught cell, that means electrode potential at the standard condition. 1 molar concentration of the electrolyte we have taken. The electrode is suspended in 1 molar concentration at 298 Kelvin. Now let us discuss how the cell potential depends upon the concentration of the electrolyte. The dependence of cell potential on the concentration of the electrolyte and also on the temperature. That is given by Fardino Nernst equation. Okay. So dependence of cell potential. Cell potential on concentration and temperature. It is called what we may call the Nernst equation. Nernst equation. The Nernst equation. Okay. Now see, we have from thermodynamics. delta g0 plus RT ln. From thermodynamics we have learnt delta g0 plus RT ln. But delta g is what will decrease in free energy. Delta g is what will decrease in free energy. Delta G is equal to decrease in standard free energy. R is what will universal gas constant. T is what to absolute temperature. And Q is what the reaction quotient. Okay, and also we have also we have minus delta G equal to NFP. Minus of delta G equal to what is NFP. This what is you can say delta G is your change in free energy. What is your change in free energy? Okay. Your change in standard free energy. Okay. Here what is your minus delta G means what is your decrease in free energy. Okay. What is your this is what is decrease in free energy. Okay, and this is what is the electrode potential, which is 9650 coulomb. And any value of number of electrons. Okay, let me see. Here also I can tell you minus delta G0 is equal to NFP0. Well, E is value of standard electron potential. Okay. Now, delta G is equal to delta G0 plus RT ln Q. Here you can say, but delta G is equal to minus delta G equal to NFP. So delta G equal to minus NFP. Okay, so simple as you can write minus NFP is equal to delta G0 what? Minus NFP0. Okay, equal to minus NFO P0 plus RT ln Q. Okay. So minus NFP is equal to minus NFE0 plus RT ln Q. Now E equal to minus NFE0 divided by minus NFO plus RT ln Q divided by minus NFP. Okay. So E equal to E0 minus RT by NFP ln Q. Okay, I can say E equal to E0 minus 2.03 RT by NFO log Q. Okay, or E equal to E0 minus 2.303 तो R इक्वल वाटर 8.314 T इक्वल वाटर इफ के सपोज वी हैव T इक्वल टू लेट T इक्वल टू 298 कर दो. ओके 298 डिवाइड बाय n इनटू 9650 F इक्वल 1 खाड़े और 9650 कूलम लॉग. Okay, on solving this, we get what you know, E equal to E0 minus 0.0591 by N log Q. This is called what you know, non-stickers. So, E is the electrode potential at given concentration and E0 is the standard electrode potential. Standard electrode potential. And Q is the radiation quotient. N is the number of electrons involved in the electrode reaction. N is what? Number of electrons involved in the electrode reaction. Okay. Now see, if we apply ratio to an electrode, okay, see, so how can you apply this equation? First of all, this Nernst equation E equal to E 0 minus 0.05 n log Q. That is what will be. If you want to calculate the electrode potential at a given concentration, then we have to calculate what the electrode potential at a standard condition minus 0.05 n log Q. Okay, how can you apply this? First of all, from the thermal energy, we have delta G equal to delta G0 plus RT ln Q. Okay, where delta G is the change in free energy. Okay, delta G is the change in standard free energy. Okay, and R is the initial gas constant, T is the absolute temperature, and Q called what is the reaction quotient. Now, and also we have delta minus delta G equal to NFE, that is for decrease in free energy. Decrease in free energy is equal to what is electrical energy. This is what is NFE, what is electrical energy. Delta minus delta G equal to NFE. This is what is electrical energy. This is what is electrical energy. Okay. So in the electrochemical cell of the galvanic cell, the decrease in free energy is converted into electrical energy minus delta G equal to NFE. Okay. Similarly, minus delta G0 equal to NF E0. Okay. So by taking this, we can put this value here. Minus NF equal to minus NF0 plus at 1 Q. Okay. Now dividing by NF, you get what? Equal to this much. Okay. Now putting the values of R universal gas to 8.314 into RT, your room temperature 298 Kelvin, you get what? E equal to E0 minus 0.05 n log Q. Okay. Now see, or if I take suppose I have an electrode M and S. Consider an electrode. M and cos plus an electrode, you got M. Okay. So here Q equal to what is M by M and cos. Your M solid by M and cos equals. So what is this one solid your one? So concentration of solid becomes 1, so 1 by 1 m plus. So here applying the Nernst equation, you get what? E electrode, EEL is equal to E0 electrode minus 0.0591 by N log Q equal to 1 by M N plus. Okay, or E electrode is equal to e 0 electrode minus plus 0.0591 by n log m n plus. So in this way we can calculate the electrode potential of a given electrode at a given concentration. Okay, because you know, the standard electrode potential is already calculated. Okay, so from that value we can calculate the potential at a given concentration. Okay, now suppose we have a cell. Okay, now suppose we have a reaction like this. We have a cell. Consider a cell. ZnZn2 plus Cu2 plus U. Cu2 plus U. Okay. So you will see the this is what this is your anode. This is what your cathode. Okay. Now a reaction. Electrode reaction, if I write reaction, Zn is what? Zn2 plus first electron and Cu2 plus first electron per Cu. So, what the reason? Zn solid, Zn2 plus aqueous, Cu2 plus aqueous, Cu solid. Okay? Now, Zn solid plus Cu2 plus aqueous will give what? Zn2 plus aqueous plus Cu solid. The net reaction. Okay. And here n equal value 2. Now, by Nernst equation, E cell equal, here this is cell, okay, E cell equal to E not cell minus 0.0591 by n log Q. Measuration question equal to what? This equal to E0 inert cell minus 0.0591 by n log. So, quotient of this reaction means what? Product by reaction. Product here, this Cu solid is 1. So, what I can write? Zn2 plus equals by this side, written side. So, Zn solid is solid equal to 1. So, what there? Cu2 plus. Okay? All can say this is equal to E naught cell minus 0.0591 by N log. Now, zinc is what to N or cathode? N or? Okay? N or? By N. E cell is equal to E naught cell minus 0.0591 by N log N by cathode. Okay? Or in terms of if you reverse it, you get a part of E cell equal to or can get E cell is equal to E naught cell plus 0.0591 by N log cathode by N. So this is the Nernst equation for calculating the electrode potential of a cell at a given concentration. Okay. So simply, whatever cell is there, you write this cell reaction. Cell reaction. Okay. Then find out the number of electrons. So n equal to here. I can put here 2. I can put here 2. Okay. Now from this net cell reaction, so you find out the product term and return. So now putting on the non-stop question. E not E cell equal to E not cell minus 0.0591 by n log what do? N by cathode or the plus cathode by anode. Okay, let us have a numerical basing on this non-stop question. Okay, let's see. Calculate the cell potential of the cell AL3 plus 0.1 molar solved with Na2 plus 0.01 molar Na. Okay, so how to calculate? Because here you see, here the molar constants are given 0.1 and 0.01. That means in this cell, so the condition is not standard. That means the constant is not 1 molar. So we have to calculate the E cell. Okay, and we know, and here we have to apply the Nernst equation. So before applying the Nernst equation, we have to calculate the E naught cell. E naught cell. Okay. So to know that, see here Al3 plus solid is Na2 plus Ni. Okay. This is part of N naught oxidation and 0.1 molar concentration. This is part of cathode reduction or 0.01 molar concentration. Okay. So 0.1 molar AL3 plus your volume, you know, is your cathode. So L is into AL3 plus. Now write here. Now calculate the E naught cell. And here you see, given here, E naught AL3 plus to L. That is RP given. Okay. So E naught AL3 plus L equal to how much? Minus 1.66 volt value. This is your RP. And again here E naught Na2 plus Ni equal to what? Minus 0.25 volt. Also what? RP. So in terms of RP, the E naught cell equal to what? E naught cathode minus E naught anode. Okay? And now, who is cathode here? With the cathode, what the value? Minus 0.25. So, minus 0.25 minus of anode. Who is anode here? This is the anode. So, minus 1.66. Equal to what? Minus 0.25 plus 1.66. Equal to what? 1.41. Okay. Now you write the cell reaction. Now what is the cell reaction? Here. The cell reaction. What is cell reaction? Al into what? Al3 plus muscle 3 local. Okay. Na2 plus 2 little what? Ni. Okay. So into 3 into 2. Are you going to write? 2L. Okay. Plus 3 Ni2 plus. We give you 2 Al3 plus also 3 Ni. Okay, Al solid एथिकस एक्वस एनेट्रोपस एक्वस एनए सर ओके तो टू एल सारे चेलेटोस इक्वेशन बाय टू एल की पास इक्वेशन बाय थ्री एन आई सर ओके हियर नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एन इक्वल वन सिक्स सिक्स इलेक्ट्रॉन्स थ्री टू ओके नाउ हियर Q equal to what the L3 plus square this is the solid divided by Na2 plus of Q okay so applying next equation we have E cell equal to E naught cell minus 0.05 by N log N naught by cathode. So here L three plus is the N naught here, which is also part of one. So here N is value L three plus you can add value equal to E naught cell minus 0.0591 by N log. Who is anode here? Who is anode here? L three plus L to L three plus is the anode here. L to L three plus. So L three plus square. Divided by cathode. Who is the cathode here? N two plus cathode here. So N two plus. Q, okay, or this is equal to inner cell. How much inner cell? 1.41 minus 0.0591 by n. How much n here? 6 here. Then log L three plus. What is the constant of L three plus here given? How much given here? 0.1 m. So 0.1 square by n a plus how much here 0.01 q here okay so we get value 10 power 4 okay or this equal to 1.041 by 0.0591 by 6 your log 0.10 power minus 2 by 10 power minus 6 okay full 10 power 4 okay so this equal to if you solve you get what is 1.04 minus 0.04 okay this equal to what is 1.37 volt. Okay, so log 10 power minus 2, okay, 0.1 and 0.1, so 0.01, so 10 power minus 2, and log 10 power 0.01 Q, so 0.01, 10 power minus 6, so 10 power 4, 4 log 10, okay, so into 4, and 1.37 volt is the answer. Okay, so this is how to solve the NOST equation. Okay, to calculate the cell potential at a given concentration. Okay, so now your electrochemical series and its applications. Okay, electrochemical series. So, how is this electrochemical series? Electrochemical series is a series where the electrode potentials of these individual electrodes are arranged with increasing order of daily reduction potential. Already we have discussed that the electrode potential of an electrode is its tendency to lose or gain electron. And it is impossible to calculate the absolute value of the electrode potential of a particular electrode because of neither oxidation nor resonance is taking place independently. So we are coupling it with the normal hydrogen electron or the standard hydrogen electron. So when you couple it with the standard hydrogen electron, the potential shown will be solely for the potential of the electron which we have taken. Now by calculating this, by calculating the potential in a rational manner, that means taking the electrode and the cathode, okay, the reduction potential of the electrode is being calculated, and the standard electrode potential of different electrodes, so coupling the hydrogen are arranged in a series manner, okay, in increasing order, that is called value electrochemical series. So in the electrochemical series, the standard electrode potential of different electrodes are given. The standard electrode potential of the hydrogen is taken 0, and others are ranging from negative value to the positive values, from lower to higher. From this series, because the electrode potential standard values are given there, from this series many information so we can find out. We can find out many information like from these values we can calculate the electrode, we can calculate the cell potential of different cells because standard electrodes potential are already given there. So we can couple it and you can calculate the cell potential by applying the formulas we already discussed. E cell in our cell equal to E cathode minus E anode in terms of its potential. And also we can predict that which will be cathode and which will be anode. When we have the series, the electrode potential values are already there. So those electrodes which have the higher reduction potential will be act at the cathode, and which have the lower reduction potential will be act at the anode. That you can calculate. And also we can calculate, we can know whether a particular reaction is feasible or not feasible. So after coupling the cell, so if we calculate the cell potential is negative, if the cell potential or EMF value of the cell is negative, that means the reaction is not feasible. If the cell potential or EMF is positive, then only the reaction is feasible. The cell is feasible. We cannot construct any cell, we cannot construct any electrode at any position. We cannot take, suppose we have an electrode action Y, we cannot take alternately anode and cathode. We must have to choose which will be cathode and which will be anode depending upon the reduction potential. Okay, so whether a particular reaction is feasible or not feasible, that we can calculate, that we can know from the electrochemical series. And also we can predict the reactivity of the elements of the metals. Those elements, those electrodes, the metals which have the higher oxidation potential will be more reactive, and those will have less one, they will be less reactive. So we can calculate the cell potential, we can predict the cathode and anode, we can predict the feasibility of reactions, and also we can predict the reactivity of the metals. So these are the four different applications of your electrochemical series. So let us have a short form of the electrochemical series, and then after we will have some applications of the electrochemical series. Okay. So see, this is the electrochemical series. I have written in short form. First of all, see, this is the electrode, these are the electrodes. Okay. And this is the electrode potential value, that is what reduction potential value. Okay, here you see we have here Li cross to Li. So when Li cross undergo reduction into Li, the standard electrode potential is what? -3.05. So the standard reduction potential of Li cross to Li is what? -3.05. Similarly, your K cross to K -2.93. Okay. So in this way, and up to some metals, so here you have L 3 plus 2 L or your -1.6 is okay. Now we have Zn 2 plus 2 Zn or your -0.76 volt. Then this to this -0.44, and you will see we have H plus 2 H 2 here 0.004. Okay. Now you see 2 plus 2 CO 0.34 volt, and finally we have F2 to F minus 2.87 volt. That means if this, if you move from this to this, the reduction potential goes on what? Increasing. This metal is having the lowest reduction potential. That means it has the highest oxidation potential. So it will undergo oxidation etching. Okay. And now you see, if you move away in the series from top to bottom, what happens? So the reduction potential value gradually going on what? Increasing. 0, then plus minus, then plus minus. That means see, the age of undergoing reduction it increases. Okay, reduction potential increases. So age of undergoing reduction increases. In the reverse manner, the oxidation potential is going on decreasing. So age of undergoing oxidation your increases. Okay, so From these values of reduction potential, so we can predict this following these things. Number one, predicting the cathode and anode. Predicting the cathode and anode. So in a particular chemical reaction, so particular electrochemical cell, which we will take as a cathode and which we will take as an anode, that we can decide from this electrochemical series. Let's see, if I have this one, suppose I have the zinc or sulfur cell, Zn, if I have question number one, if I have zinc copper sulfur cell, you will see Zn into Zn 2 plus into Zn and CO2 plus into CO. See, in this series we see Zn 2 plus 2 Zn, what is the value? -0.76. What is your -0.76 volt value RP. If you go for CO2 plus 2 CO, what is the value here? 0.34 volt. What is your 0.34 volt? So here CO2 plus 2 CO is having 0.34, and this one low, -2.76 volt to reduction potential. So because the copper is having the higher reduction potential, copper will undergo reduction. So this is the cathode. And zinc is having the lower reduction potential, that means it is having the higher oxidation potential, so it will be treated at the anode. So when you construct this cell, we will take the zinc electrode in the anodic half cell. We cannot take it in the cathodic half cell. Okay, because zinc is having the lower reduction potential, that is what? Higher oxidation potential, that means it will be treated as an anode, and this is a cathode. So whenever we are constructing an electrochemical cell, which electrode will be anode, which will be cathode, that we can predict from this series. Okay. So from here you see Zn CO2 positive, Zn2 positive. This is the cell. So Zn2, Zn2, Zn2 positive value. This is value. Anode. And CO2 positive is value. So if you write the cell, if you write the cell here, what you can write? You can write here Zn, Zn2, Zn2 plus anode, then hard CO2 plus. So in this case, so Zn will be hard, the anode is will be hard. Okay. Next one. Number two. Also, we can calculate the cell potential. Calculate the cell potential. For example, see, calculate the inner cell of this cell. CO2, CO2 plus A, A plus A. And here, see, here, CO2, CO2, CO2 plus is what? In the left hand side, and A plus A is in the right hand side. Now, see, if we find this in the series, E naught of CO2 plus 2 CO is equal to how much? 0.34 volt, 0.34 volt. And E naught of AG plus 2 AG, how much? How much is your AG plus 2 AG? How much is AG plus 2 AG? 0.80. Okay? So, that means CO2 plus is having 0.34 volt and this is your 0.80 volt. So, A plus A is in the higher RP. So it undergo reaction and it is hard in the cathode. And CO2 plus 2 CO is having the lower RP, that is, you know, lower RP, that is one low. Higher RP, that is one low. Anode. Okay? Undergo oxidation. So now E cell, inner cell equal to here, what I can add? Inner term. Cathode minus E naught to anode. Who is the cathode here? A plus to A is the cathode here. 0.0 RP. 0.80. Minus of CO2 plus the cathode anode here. Cathode minus anode. Cathode minus anode. 0.34. Convert 0.46 volt. So in this way, we can calculate the cell potential from this electrochemical series value. Okay. Then number three, predict the feasibility of variation. See, the feasibility of operations depends upon the cell potential. If the cell potential or EMF of value of the cell is positive, the cell is variation is feasible. If the cell potential or EMF is negative, the variation is not feasible. Okay, here you see, predict the feasibility of variation. So check the feasibility of the in this one given here. See what is given here? CU number 3 function. Okay, CU into what? CU2 plus. So plus electron, then Zn2 plus electron, then given here. So CU plus Zn2 plus 2, CU2 plus Zn. And so CU into CU2 plus and Zn2 plus into Zn. So you know, you see E naught to CU2 plus 2 CU. Okay, in our CO2 plus 2 CO is how much here? 0.34 volt to RP. Okay, and in our Zn2 plus 2, then here Zn2 plus 2, then given here, how much here? Minus 0.76 volt. अब एक प्रति क्वेश्चन है और शिव इनटू शिव टू प्लस तो शिव शिव टू प्लस शिव शिव टू प्लस सॉल्व कीजिए जेन टू प्लस जेन माइनस वन जेन टू प्लस टू जेन ताने सी दिस इज दी एनर्जी और दी द कैथोड है सवाल इतना है ई सेल इक्वल टू इनर सेल इक्वल टू इनर टू कैथोड माइनस इनर टू हार्ट फिर एनो सो इनर कैथोड हुई दी कैथोड है जी ओके दैट इज व्हाट माइनस 0.76 माइनस 0.76 माइनस आपको व्हाट हो इनर इनर टू एनर विद एनर हो कॉपर द एनर हो हाउ मच द वैल्यू 0.34 और बात माइनस 1.12 व्हाट जानवे से दी ईएमएफ वैल्यू इज व्हाट माइनस विच इज नॉट पॉसिबल दैट मींस दिस इज नॉट फिजिबल ओके सो इफ द ई सेल इनर सेल इन योर बिजी पॉजिटिव वैल्यू देन ओनली डिरेक्शन फिजिबल एंड हियर यू फाइंड आउट व्हाट योर नेगेटिव सो दी डिरेक्शन इज व्हाट नॉट फिजिबल ओके सो नेक्स्ट वन the relativity of the metals we can find out the relativity you see in this series the electrons are arranged with the increasing order of reduction potential okay that means if you reverse it this will be what you know decreasing order of oxidation potential okay And the metal which have higher oxidation potential is highly reactive as compared to other. Those are having the higher oxidation potential are high reactive as compared to others. So if you compare here the metals of the present here, they suppose this one, you know, zinc, you have 0.76 of oxidation potential and that of Fe will be 0.44 Op. Okay, so those metals which are higher Op can disperse the metals in the lower oxidation potential. Okay, for example, here you see, you can say AgNO3 cannot be stored in copper vessel, but copper sulfide can be stored in the silver vessel. Now see, if I write E naught. Ag plus Ag equal to 0.80 and E naught Cu2 plus Cu is how much? 0.34 okay so if you see this one is yellow higher Rp higher Rp okay that's what is lower Op this what is the lower Rp this what is higher Op so when we have this so AgNO3 in copper vessel the copper will undergo oxidation It will disperse the silver. Okay, but when we have copper sulfate in the ideal vessel, okay, it cannot disperse. Okay, so because of this, you see, this copper is what is higher oxidation potential as compared to silver. So copper will disperse silver. Will disperse silver. So when AgNO3 vessel when AgNO3 is stored in the copper vessel, the copper will disperse silver, okay, and we get what copper lead. But when copper sulfide is present in silver, okay, because silver is having the lower oxidation potential, so it cannot oxidize. Okay, so that's why AgNO3 can be stored in the copper vessel, but copper sulfide can never be stored in the silver vessel. Similarly, another example I can say. It will take Cu plus H2 support. No H2 gas. But then pass H2 support. Pardon. Then S support. Pass H2. So what happens here? See, Cu E naught C2 plus Cu equal to 0.34 volt.
Okay?
And E naught H plus H2 is what? 0.0 volt. E naught ZL 2 plus ZL is what? -0.6 volt. So, when you take copper, Cu and H2 support, Cu is having the higher RP, so lower oxygen potential as compared to anion. That means it cannot oxidize. Okay? But when we have the zinc in H2 support, zinc is having what? The -0.6 volt of RP, so 0.76 volt of OP. That is more than hydrogen. So it can oxidize or it can displace hydrogen. Okay, because zinc is having higher oxygen potential, okay, it can displace your hydrogen gas, but copper is having more, so it cannot displace your hydrogen gas. Okay, so these are the applications of what your electrochemical theory, and this is all about your electrochemistry. Thank you.